That'll do it. The antennas are still.
Sorry, that was my fault. I moved it because I need to get the windows open and front to my back.
That's all good. Okay. Jeff Scott, I didn't know what that means. Yeah, all this should be digital. You guys are fine.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the LRSD presentation of Winnipeg High School football. We're here tonight for our first game of the evening, and we invite you ahead of time to join our second game at 8 o'clock. My name is Brian Cameron. I'm with my new friend and colleague, Dan Washnuck, and we will be calling the game for you tonight between Vincent Massey, Brandon, and the Sturgeon Heights.
Huskies.
Thanks, Brian. Vincent Massey Vikings and Sturgeon Heights Huskies. Welcome and join us. We're looking for a very exciting game tonight. Lots of things to think about as we look into going to our first game. What do you think we're going to see, Dan?
Well, we've got two really good quarterbacks here. And as much as number 28 for Vincent Massey Brandon, Braden Smith, can run the ball, they've got no problem trying to take their shots downfield either. And on the other side, Sturgeon Heights Huskies quarterback returns from last year. That's Brendan McCammon, and he's been having a really good year again. He's a great run threat. Like, he was probably the best player on the field last week against Vincent Massey Collegiate, the Trojans there. This has been something he's done his entire high school career, is he's been a run threat, but he's especially dangerous when he gets out on the run, gets the perimeter, and can start trying to take some shots downfield. So it's neat seeing two really similar teams meet again in a situation like this and back on the same field that they played last year.
So we are looking at game conditions right now are about plus one degrees outside, with a wind out of the southwest of about 17 gusting to 35, according to our latest forecast. How do you think that's going to impact the game tonight?
Being a little sheltered here in the stadium, I think they're going to be all right. Anytime you get near that 20-kilometer-an-hour wind, it starts affecting a little bit of the game plan, but having that little bit of a bowl here is probably going to help the teams out in their passing game. The gusts might get a little interesting, but just looking at the flags on the goalposts, not seeing a ton of action there. So I think we're going to be able to see both teams kind of implement the game plan they came in with.
Looking forward to some just good old prairie football.
Yeah.
You know, the league starts in such a time when the temperatures are reasonable, and we did have a warm fall, but this is the way it is in November, folks.
Absolutely.
Looking forward to an excellent game between two really good teams.
Yeah, it's nice that, you know, we have this rematch, as I mentioned already. You know, last time these teams met was last year in the AA championship. And You know, it's too bad that both of these teams just missed out on those provincial playoffs with their 4-3 records. You know, some tiebreaker shenanigans got involved. But here they are having won great bowl semi-games, and here they are competing for the VIdruk Bowl, giving them a chance for some meaningful postseason action.
So Sturgeon Heights defeated Vincent Massey Winnipeg 12-10 to get here tonight. And the Vincent Massey Vikings beat Garden City 28-8 to get here. So, you know, just happened last week, getting into the ends of things. This will be the final game of the season for these two teams. So one of them will be victorious.
Yeah, it's, I had a chance to watch the Sturgeon and Massey Winnipeg. And you'll forgive me, I'm going to say Massey Winnipeg probably all night. You know, we know that the Massey Collegiate versus Massey High School. But I know for me, it's always just easier to work the geographic. So when they were playing Massey Winnipeg last week, they were in that that snowfall. It was just after, and East Side is where they were playing. They weren't able to get their tractor going. So they were playing at about 5 inches of snow last week. And that... That really affected a lot of the game plan, I'm sure. I didn't have a chance to see the Massey Brandon Garden City game, unfortunately, but I know that that aforementioned running back for Massey Brandon, Braden Smith, I know he had just a ton of yards on the ground. So it'll be interesting to see if he's able to replicate that today against a pretty stingy Huskies defense.
Sorry, folks, we forgot to mention this is the VIdruk Bowl. Both teams that are in there tonight are Sturgeon Heights Huskies versus the Vincent Massey Vikings from Brandon. Just did the coin toss. I'm trying to figure out who actually won. Ahead of time, I do want to invite you to join us again later tonight on LRSD TV, as we are going to broadcast the second of our games tonight, as well as we actually have three games tomorrow starting at 2 o'clock, then 5 o'clock. And 8 o'clock. More great Winnipeg High School football action.
Yeah, I'm with you, Ryan. I missed the results of the coin toss. I'm still not really sure. I see Sturgeon's head coach, Eric Vincent, is also their defensive coordinator, is out talking to the special teams right now. So they're getting ready to put their team out. And based on the bodies that are there, I don't even want to guess. Tempted to guess.
I did see.
Oh, I see. Okay. Looks like Massey Brandon's going to be kicking off to Sturgeon.
Yeah, I did see one of the Sturgeon Heights players indicating that they were going to be receiving the football.
Oh,
so I think Vincent Massey will be kicking off.
Good. Yeah, and now we got Coach Steves from the Vikings is talking to his kickoff team, getting ready to get things going here. And these are two teams that, again, you know, they haven't met in a year, but I'm sure they're still really familiar with each other. You know, Coach Vincent is that defensive coordinator. He's been there for years. He's a product of the Manitoba Bison. We got Coach Brady Dane is the offensive coordinator for the Massey Brandon Vikings, and he's been having a really successful couple years here working.
Colt Mallion is back.
Working his systems.
Along with number 22, pardon me, Owen Highland is back, along with Jabari Marshall for the Huskies.
So as Vincent Massey lines up for the first kickoff, I guess they feel that they're going to need to have someone
Christian
hold the...
Christian Williamson to kick off the ball for the Vikings.
Christian Williamson will kick off for Vincent Massey. And we are off.
Ooh.
Direct kicked almost.
Number 90.
Looks like number 90 from Stelfenites.
For the Huskies.
Yeah, it's Kerry Duncalf.
Like Zach Redekop was there to lead the tacklers in for the Vikings. First and 10 for the Huskies. Ball is spotted at their own 43-yard line.
Yeah, folks, and over here it's going quiet right now. I'm not sure if in your feed that you're getting the stadium announcer like we are. So if you're hearing us kind of get cut off, that's what's going on. If you're hearing it as well, then hopefully you're enjoying those dulcet tones too.
Sturgeon Heights will take their first set of downs, first and 10 from their own 43-yard line.
Pass play. There's their jet sweep.
In a shotgun, it's jet sweep, and caught in the backfield for a loss.
Brendan McCammon, the ball carrier.
Brendan McCammon takes the ball, but is caught for about what looks like about a 2 to 3 yard loss. So a good read by the Vincent Massey defense to see that and read that well ahead of time.
Yeah, we see Sturgeon, they're coming out with their usual wing set where they're putting that fullback down, number 85, on the right side of the defensive right side of the field right now. Number 10, who's playing their left slot, who just took the handoff there, he's usually their running back, so it's neat to see him out in that receiver position. And there's the corner route, and it's immediately picked off.
The pass is intercepted by the Vikings.
And that's a staple of the Sturgeon Heights offense, is they want to try and hit those corner routes from the slot backs.
And Christian Williamson is there to pick off that ball. First and 10 Vikings. Ball is placed directly on the midfield stripe.
So here comes Massey Brandon. They're probably going to be in their usual two-back set. So number 28. Oh, we're coming out in a wishbone. So looking like a three-back set here to start. And I'm pretty sure Brandon has too many players on the field, so I think they're going to take a timeout on this one.
Well, that was quick right off the bat. We're not even a full 2 minutes into the game, and we're using up a timeout already.
Well, you know, excited, last game of the year. You just want to be out on the field. Looks like Massey Brandon is trying to catch maybe Sturgeon with something they haven't shown on tape before. Again, I haven't seen everything on field. But it looks like Coach Vincent, the DC, is already talking to his coaches, talking to his players about what they can expect.
Vincent Massey's first set of downs right at midfield, first and 10 from the 55-yard line.
Okay, they are staying in that wishbone. So we're going to be maybe a little bit more of a power run here at the evening. Starting off with a power lead, just trying to get off tackle and get some yards.
And Josh Palmer hands off to
Braden Smith, number 28.
Braden Smith, number 28.
That's a gain,
looks like
of, seven
a gain of about
play,
7 yards. Good first run for a good first play for the Vincent Massey Vikings.
Yeah, really nice play by Derek Papenoon here from Sturgeon to come up in some run support. He's kind of that floating halfback against this extra running back. So for him to stick his nose in there is a great play for him.
So under center again. Hands off and finding lots of room to the right side of the field. Tackled after a gain of about 10 yards.
That's going to be the game for Sturgeon is, can they deal with that counter tray? You know, Massey Brandon pulls those linemen so well, and if the linebackers don't have great eye discipline, aren't able to get to their run fits, they're going to have a hard time today. That was a great pull from the left guard and left tackle of Massey Brandon there.
First and 10 from the Sturgeon Heights 38-yard line. And Palmer is under center, pitches out, and looking for some room to the left side, but nothing there this time. Tackled on the play by, it looks like, number 90. So good pursuit, a loss of 2 yards on the play.
2 yards on the play, making it second and 12 for the Vikings.
Already seeing Massey Brandon trying to kind of test Sturgeon here, getting to the perimeter on that play, trying to get that waggle down from the wide receiver to crack the end and just trying to set that edge. But really good job by number 70, the halfback on the other side, coming up in run support. Sturgeon's doing a good job using cover three, having some deep safety sets as run support.
Palmer directly under center. I wasn't sure if there might have been an offside call there, as I saw one of the defensive linemen from Sturgeon Heights jump a bit, but no call.
Yeah, it looks like he didn't get into the neutral zone, so our side judge, a little generous on that one, but I don't know that he entered the neutral zone, and I don't have that vision that the ref does.
So that will make it actually third and 12.
Vincent Campbell is back along with Owen Highland.
And it appears that Vincent Massey
Christian
will
Williamson
be punting from there.
For the Vikings.
Sturgeon's got two back, so it doesn't look like they're going to try and block this one. Looks like they're trying to set up the return.
Oh, he got a fake, and he's going to find some room to the right side.
That's a first.
More than enough, and actually almost to the right to the 15-yard line. Sorry, folks, I got so excited about that play. What a great play that my tongue got tripped up, but what a great play by the Vincent Massey Vikings to find some room, set up, but find some room down the right-hand side of the field and right down to the Sturgeon Heights 15-yard line. Actually, all the way to the 13-yard line.
It's been a great opening drive for the Vikings here. Coach Dane has been doing some good work, and that was a great gutsy call from Coach Steves to go after that that third down fake.
So first and 10, Palmer underneath center. Willie hands it out. Find a bit of room up the middle, but not as much this time. Maybe a gain of about 3 yards.
much better job on that Braden counter Smith, tray the there carry. From number 27, Luke Bennett of the Huskies. He had really nice eye discipline there. He saw those pullers, and he was able to move himself
that'll
into where
be
he needed to be.
Second and seven for the Vikings with the ball
second
at the
10-yard
line.
From their own, from the Husky 10-yard line.
Oh, really nice wrong arm from number 90, Sturgeon there, too, on the replay. Did a great job stuffing that point of attack and forcing the cutback lane to number 27.
Palmer under center. He'll hand it off and finding someone right to the right side,
touchdown,
up the middle.
Touchdown,
Vincent Massey, and they will open the scoring.
That's a great downhill run from that team. That's their bread and butter all year, is letting Braden Smith kind of run wild there. Lead, counter Trey, any way they can get him going north-south and get some yards, they're going to be working that all year.
So Vincent Massey will set up for the point after. Just a little note here, folks, as you can probably imagine, the Vincent Massey Vikings, great team, but we can have a difficult time seeing the numbers on their jerseys as they are purple on purple. But that opening score now makes it 7-0 for Vincent Massey as they take the lead in the 2023 VIdruk Bowl.
The convert.
7:17 left in the first quarter. We'll see how the Sturgeon Heights Huskies will respond to this. But what a great series, what a great set of downs for Vincent Massey, especially that fake.
As you see on this kickoff as well, do they kind of try and put it deep again, or is it going to be number 90, Kerry Dunkoff's opportunity to get another return here if they throw another knuckler right at him in the middle of the field there? Well, there's that deep kick. I'm sure that's what they're trying to get. It's in the hands. Ooh.
Nice kick.
Fighting over it. Number 22.
Number 22 from Sturgeon Heights finds and cuts to his left side. Finds a bit of room and comes all the way up to the 40. So that's where Sturgeon Heights will start their second series of the VIdruk Bowl. Good run by number 22 from Sturgeon Heights.
Yeah, I think we'll be hearing his name a lot today, too.
That would be first and 10 Huskies with the ball at their own 40-yard line.
Between him and number 10, they kind of take turns in the backfield, but it looks like they're both on the field again here. So my guess is they're going to stay in that same package with number 10. And slot receiver is kind of a jet threat. Number 85 down on the wing, and Massey Brandon coming out in a 50 front to deal with that wing.
McCammon continues in the shotgun, and number 22 just talked
Owen
about
Highland,
him.
The ball carrier.
Owen Highland finds a bit of room up the middle. Gets about four, maybe five yards. So about half of it. Well, about four, it looks like.
Needs to see if Coach Barabo, who's new to the Husky staff, also a former Bison product there. Be interesting to see if he starts trying to take a look at if Massey Brandon's going to walk up to that sing look. But now they're in a second and long, medium situation here. They're in their 5R set. So are they trying to space things out for their quarterback, or are they trying to throw the ball?
McCammon actually puts his ball up and is intercepted again.
Intercepted by the Vikings.
Second interception of the game and picked up at their Sturgeon Heights' own 50-yard line.
Yeah, almost the exact spot of the field where that first interception was thrown. You know, I don't hate that play call at all. I don't hate that ball. It's just a little delayed and a great turnaround from the Massey defender, and I missed his
that
number.
First and 10 for the Vikings with the ball at
but
the
Massey defense, especially his defensive backs, are kind of built on speed and built on closing. Like two of them, Zach Redicock, number
that was
four,
Ashton and Ham on the interception for the Vikings.
Christine Williamson, number nine. They're both provincial medalists.
So first and 10 from their 50-yard line, and will pitch back and find a bit of room
Braden
to
Smith,
the right
ball
side.
Tripped up in the play by Aiden
a gain
Gosek.
Of about 3 yards.
Yeah, just to finish that thought, they have two provincial medalists in the 4x1 and triple jump on Massey Brandon's defensive. So they're all about speed out there, and it's kind of showing that closing speed right now. That was another great tackle for number 71 from Sturgeon.
That'll be second and seven for the Vikings.
Second and seven from the 47-yard line.
Yeah, Sturgeon up in this cover three shell,
hands
really playing run support.
This time looking for something on the left-hand side,
Braden
but
Smith,
nothing
the
there.
Carry.
That will make it, well, not to say nothing, but only about
Kerry
3 yards. Not enough for a first down.
The stop for the Huskies.
Vincent Massey will be forced to punt the ball away.
Looks like they're going to leave their offense out there. Kind of caught in no man's land where they're thinking, you know, maybe not worth the yardage they'll get out of a punt. If
also
they don't convert, defense
70.
Has been playing great. So, you know, why not get after it here?
And that'll be third and five for the Vikings.
A little bit more in Winnipeg and high school football than in some of the other football we see, which is good. Right. I like it. Rolling out to his left-hand side and then throwing the ball up. Oh, knocked down. I don't know. I'm just throwing it out there, Dan, if that was actually intended for the player who knocked it down.
Well, you know, you got a little bit of confusion when you got two receivers kind of coming off the field, both patting their chest. We had a little bit of a sail concept from Massey Brandon there with a few different levels of outs and a vertical on the outside. And there was three outs. You normally only see two out of that set. So I think two running backs released to the flats when only one was supposed to. So we'll see if Sturgeon can capitalize on their best field position of the day, I think.
I think you're right, and really no damage from the interception because they're sort of getting the ball back about where they lost it.
QB counter Trey, there's
those
pullers.
So looking to find some room, but no, gets baby
Brendan
back
McCavin,
to the
ball carrier.
The scrimmage line.
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, I think that was number four. If that was number four, that's one of those speedsters I just talked about. Zach Redikoff coming down from the safety position. All right, Ryder Desjardins apparently is the one who made the tackle there. But whoever it was had some great eye discipline on that, was patient, didn't worry about the jet motion, was able to find those pullers and close on McCammon.
So McCammon back in the shotgun, seems to like that, puts it up and caught on the play. Close to a first down, caught on the play by number 15.
Oh, I think they're going to be generous and give it to him here. I think they should. That's a great catch and a great run. They're moving the sticks. That's the other thing that Sturgeon loves. They get those corner routes that they like to hit, and they love those in-breaking routes, their drags, their slants, and McCammon put it right on target and let him run after the catch for that first down yardage. So it's nice to see him get a nice rhythm throw there and not worry about those former interceptions.
Caught on the play by Malik Kamara, who I think probably got pulled back, and it made it look like he didn't get it, but he did get enough. So first down, hand up on the inside, and well read by the Vincent Massey Vikings defense. Tackled in the backfield for a loss.
Newman Chiquato on the tackle for the Vikings. That'll be second and 12 for the Huskies.
So that will make it second, and it actually looks about 13 yards. I think they lost three.
Yeah, I'd agree with you. That's a loss three. In their 5R set, Massey Brandon running a prowler package where they're trying to get some confusion.
This time looking for some room up the middle, but nothing really there. A gain of, let's say about 5 yards.
On the play by Hudson,
but
Grosso.
Closed on pretty quickly once again by the Vincent Massey defense.
That brings up third and about 8 yards to go for the Huskies.
So that will make it third and eight.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that was serendipitous of the Vikings there. They were kind of either trying to run a package where you don't necessarily have any set down linemen, you want to bring some confusion, or they were actually confused about where they're supposed to be set. Either way, hard time for the Huskies to identify
Gabriel
their blocks
McCauley and Zach Redikoff
nowhere for McCannon to go there.
So McCannon will continue
in punt formation for the Huskies.
Got an onside player here, number 11.
Blocking, pardon me.
Number 11 can collect this punt if he gets
pardon
down
me,
there.
That was Carson Turner on the punt.
Played clean.
Fielded at about the 30-yard line, about a 5-yard gain. So Vincent Massey will take
Derek
over for the next series from
their
own 35-yard line. A minute 52 left
ball
in the first
is placed
quarter.
At the 35-yard line.
7-0 with the Vincent Massey Vikings in the lead.
Yeah, I mentioned that Sturgeon started off with probably their best field position on their last drive. Well, this is going to be the worst field position that the Brandon Vikings have here. So we'll see if they're able to walk the field and put some points up before the end of the quarter.
Palmer under center looks to his left side and over top of the fingers of his intended receiver.
Intended on the play for Logan Sutton.
To me, like number zero.
Pardon me,
correct.
Intended for Lucas Ewart.
Yeah, that's a good job from Coach Dane, the offense coordinator there. He identified that cover three shell that Sturgeon's running where they've got their three DBs already back pre-snap. And this is something Sturgeon likes to do as kind of a run-stopping coverage. Have those corners back spying the run, have the halfback stepping up to help out on the run, but it makes susceptible to plays like bubble screen. Just didn't connect.
Palmer under center. Hands off and looking for some room up the middle, but not much there. Maybe a gain of three or four yards.
Ball carrier.
And there's that counter tray again from Massey Brandon, bringing both pullers. But again, number 90 for Sturgeon, who's already having a really good game. Kerry Duncalf, you know, and mentioned him as a returner. Had a great wrong arm there, taking on that first puller and stuffing the point of attack. And then number 53 for the Huskies, I believe they call him DJ, had some great eye discipline, Vincent found his Campbell's run fit, and was able to make that tackle. Huskies.
So Vincent Massey will
Jamari
be
Wilson
punting.
Also back for the Huskies.
Ball is up, kind of hanging up there, and comes down just over
the
midfield line. Fielded right away and blown dead by the referees. Fielded by number 70 from the Sturgeon Heights.
Yeah, those of you at home who are wondering why they blew that play dead, we have a rule in amateur football here that if the ball's coming down on a short-ish punt like that, they only netted about 15 yards or so from line of scrimmage. If it's coming down in a crowd, the refs are just going to blow that dead and award possession to the return team just to avoid any potential collisions that might happen in that pile there.
So McCammon continues in the shotgun, two receivers to his right. He rolls to his left. Puts the ball up and
so
pass
close.
Is incomplete.
So close. Just tipped away from his intended receiver.
Very neat little play from Coach Baribo here. They run a false puller. They have the offensive left guard half pulls. He pulls and then wheels back around to set up that play action boot. Really neat little play. Didn't quite get the protection he was hoping for his quarterback, but really neat little concept they're trying to do there.
McCammon continues from shotgun, two receivers to his right, three to his left, and he is looking to pass again.
Pass is
great pass breakup.
Intended on the play for Parker Herosian.
Caught, but then knocked away, just not enough to count as a catch. On the play by number three, Carson Turner.
Carson Turner had a great game last week against Vincent Massey Collegiate. He was a big part of them being able to put away that game in the snow there, and you know, got some hands on that ball. That's a great in-breaking route. McCammon put it in the right spot, but just a great pass breakup from the Brandon defensive back there, or linebacker. Again, I'm not really sure which number it was, but that was a great football play. Good protection, good ball, great pass breakup.
So that was the end of the first quarter, so that now switches us over, and we are into the second quarter. So they switch sides of the field. It is third and 10.
Looks like they do have their punt team out. But it kind of looks like they're missing their punter. Yeah, it's tough to punt without a punter.
Yeah.
So they're just going to take that delay of game, get their personnel correct, and then take it from there. Sorry, there's that American football fan coming out of me. Going to take the time count violation, not the delay of game.
Yeah, so it seems like their punter, Carson Turner's just coming on the field.
And that's interesting because normally I believe their punter is Dylan Johnson, number 9, so I wonder if he
Carson
shook up somewhere.
Turner in a punt formation for the Huskies. Zach Redekop and Gabriel McCauley
are deep
for the
Vikings. And if he is, that would be the reason for taking that 5-yard penalty.
Yeah, and when you're punting, that 5 yards isn't the end of the world either.
Good kick by Turner.
Ooh, dies. Oh, they're going to get the no yards there.
Hudson Broso comes up with the football, and there's a flag in the play.
So they get a no yards penalty. And what's a no yards penalty look like in high school football? Yeah.
So if it hits the ground and it's that dribbled ball, it's only going to be a minimum penalty of 5 yards. If it is caught in the air, it carries like that restriction zone foul, takes a little bit of a heavier toll. To be perfectly honest with you, I can't remember if it's just 10 here in high school caught in the air. I believe it is, but it's either 10 or 15. And I believe for most amateur leagues, because it is amateur football, because the punts typically aren't as long, it's usually a 10-yard. So because that hit the ground, it's just a 5-yard. It looks like Massey Brandon's playing their backup quarterback right now.
Looking for some room on the right-hand side, getting about 6 yards.
Josh,
so good
Pond
run from the Vincent Massey Vikings running back.
Tackle on the play by Derek Papunin. Also in on that stop was Vincent Campbell.
Yeah, it looks like Colton Malion is in the quarterback right now. And I was watching him during pregame, and he can definitely sling it around a little bit. But I am surprised to see him in the game right now.
Especially so soon. Holds off and looking to the left-hand side, but caught right away by number 90. From Sturgeon Heights, good cover. Scott Sherb. So well read by the Sturgeon Heights defense, and it keeps the score and gives them the ball back. Keeps the score at 7-0.
Yeah, I'm seeing number 8, Josh Palmer for the Brandon Vikings, is on the sidelines. Doesn't look like he's being attended to right now. So be interesting to see if we do see him back out on the field tonight.
Along with Vincent Campbell.
I mean, we knew that Braden Smith was going to be that workhorse for the Vikings tonight, but he may have an even more enhanced load.
Christian Williamson in punt formation for the Vikings.
Ball is up. Fielded at about the 44-yard line, finding not much room there, and it will be no yards.
Well, the play. Here we go. It looks like I'm about to get my answer. So that ball is fielded in the air, and it does look like they're going to toss for their straining zone foul here, the no yards.
The football for
so
the Huskies.
We'll see if they walk this off 10 or 15 yards. I'm feeling pretty confident about 10, though.
No yards. Vincent Massey, number 90, 15-yard penalty.
Oh, it is 15.
Down. Oh, that's
looks
a big
like our league chooses
penalty.
Not to.
And
yeah,
first and 10 penalty. For the Huskies with the ball at the Vikings 50-yard line.
So Sturgeon Heights will start at pretty much close to their best position of the game so far. 50-yard line, 9:46 left in the second quarter. McCammon backs up and is looking for something, but is sacked just on the play.
Brendan McCammon is dropped for a loss on the play.
And it looks like a big loss of about 6-7 yards.
Coach Steve, pretty excited. I think he thought he saw a fumble on the field there. He came out to almost the numbers in excitement there. So doesn't look like the ref saw it the way the coach did, but we got can't be upset if you're
Roger
a Viking right now.
On the tackle
able
the
to
Vikings,
get them into a second and long situation.
For the Huskies.
Defensive line can kind of pin their ears back. DBs can start playing a little more ball hawk. But they are still saying they're single pack here, so let's see if they get a rollout. Screen.
Looking for a bit of a rush and a screen play. Looking for some room up the left-hand side. Cutting inside.
He's
and getting
it.
More
complete
than the first down.
Highland.
Great run on the play.
That's
well played
great
by the Sturgeon Heights
Coach,
Huskies.
From Coach Barrow.
Tackle
nice
on the
call.
Play by Caleb Edwards. That'll be
number
a first 22, down for the
Huskies. Owen Highland.
Been all over the field tonight already. That's a great screen pass, great patience.
I think that's easily their longest play of the day today, Dan.
I think you're right, Brad.
Cameron in the shotgun.
Showing that pass set again. Is there going to be a jet motion? There's the jet motion. There's the jet sweep.
Oh, finds a bit of room to the left side, but
brought down the ball carrier.
Maybe two.
Number 24 on the tackle there for the Brandon Vikings.
Tackle on the play by
Ryder Desjardins. He's been flying around a lot today as well. And that's the downside of running that jet action. It's great to kind of spread the defense out, but you got to run a long way to get 2 yards. And if the defense can sniff it out quickly and close, it's, a lot of running for not a lot of payout.
Second and 8.
We're at second and 8.
3 receivers to his right, 2 to his left.
A little bit of press from the Vikings here, kind of dropping off with almost a cut shell here. And there's that quarterback
McCammon
draw.
McCammon finds some room
so
up the
dangerous.
Middle, but he will be short of the first
Brendan
down.
McCammon,
only coming
ball
over just inside the 20-yard line. Needed the 17.
Tackle on the play by Joshua Timotope.
So he's going to be a couple yards short.
Watching Coach Vincent now, he's the excited one, sprinting down to look at the spot, deciding
the
do we want to go or do we want to kick the field goal here. I think he's going to leave his offense out on the field.
He is leaving his offense on the field. He's sending in a play. They need about 2 yards. Big play for the Sturgeon Heights Huskies.
That's a benefit of the Brandon Vikings playing in that cover one, maybe cut shell there, is letting the linebackers really continue to play the run. Showing a lot of a massive front here from Brandon, really trying to take away the lanes.
And he is going to pass the ball. Oh,
pass
almost intercepted.
By Christian Williamson, and the ball goes over to the Vikings.
Vincent Massey
on
will take over on downs.
Vincent Massey.
And there's that closing speed from those DBs again. You know, speed kills in defense. And when you can play cover one and close like that, you can have a lot of success letting your linebackers play the run, letting your D-line do what they do. If your DBs can close and make plays in man coverage, it frees up a lot of things in the box.
Armchair coach time, Dan. Would you have run the ball?
I like that decision. You've got a great quarterback there. They've got a six-man front up in your face. It's tough to run the ball against big bodies like that. I don't think you can ever say this was the right choice, but I think that they wish they could have a redo on it.
And I would say that Vincent Massey's defensive line has been
play
playing
action.
Very well.
They're taking a poke here. That's a tug.
Oh intercepted. What great range by number 23. From Sturgeon Heights to come in and intercept that ball.
I thought that was six.
That's my fault for jinxing it with the tug call there. You see that no safety look. You see them get behind the DBs. You just hope the quarterback can put it on them. But what a great play from number 23 there, Daniel Visa. And he had a huge interception last week against Massey Collegiate as well that set up the game-winning drive for them. So he's been kind of really showing out in these playoffs, number 23, Daniel Visa has.
First and 10 from the 32-yard line, 6 minutes left in the second quarter. Hands off and looking for some room upside, but nothing there.
Owen Highland, the ball carrier.
Once again, well read by the Vincent Massey front line.
Yeah, Newman Chiwato there, number 74, really getting in the backfield again. And
that'll be second and 10 for the Huskies.
Really explosive, powerful defensive front for the Vikings has been really putting in the work already today.
So no gain, right just to the line of scrimmage?
Back in their 5-R set, doesn't look like they're going to try another poke at the screen here.
McCammon back, and he is looking to pass down the field, but nothing there.
Number 74 again.
And Brendan McCammon is
sacked on the
loss
play by number 74 from Vincent Massey.
Also one on that stop was Scott Sherb.
And that is Newman Chiquato.
Yeah, and Scott Sherb got in there as well. That's someone that Coach Steve's told me is a big, important part of their team. I know that he was dominant last year. He's been dominant this year. But between he and number 74, number 90 and 74 combining
Zach
there again.
Redkopp and Christian
now,
Williams
one thing to keep an eye out for there is number 5, the quarterback for the Huskies, Brett McCammon, kind of came up holding his thigh there. So hopefully there's nothing bugging him too much. Hopefully that was just more of an impact thing and nothing that's going to bother him the rest of the game.
They are checking on him, but he appears to be okay.
Carson Turner in punt formation for the Huskies.
Well, I will tell you, I don't know if Sturgeon Heights can take that much time because I think it just works against
the punt bounces out of bounds at the 12-yard line.
Them in terms of how quickly and how much power up front that the Vincent Massey Vikings have in terms of being able to come at them. So great play by Vincent Massey.
Yeah, and that's another benefit of saying earlier with the Brandon being able to run that cover one. You're not going to necessarily have early windows in cover one. So McCammon's kind of holding on to that ball, which against cover three, against zone, you got those three deep defenders. You can find windows. You can let the receivers get themselves open. But against cover one, that ball's got to come out quick. But Brandon's been making them pay for it today, too.
So the punt goes out of bounds at the 12-yard line, and Vincent Massey would take over first and 10 from their own 12-yard line.
Right
hands
back to
off
the bread and
looking
butter
for some left side and wide open, not much room. Somebody better track him down.
Braden Smith, the ball carrier.
Well done. Good track down from the Sturgeon Heights Huskies defense. But what a great run. And just finding that gap in the middle there.
Well, it's coming back, unfortunately. And it's too bad because that was a great lead. The fullback came through, and I missed his number. I wish I could say to it because that fullback is so key to that play. And it might have been number 15 who got flagged. I thought it was a great block, but he really opened that lane up. The O-lineman made a huge B-gap, and Braden Smith had nothing but space, and that's a dangerous kid to let get out into the open field. But holding is holding is holding, and that is a costly penalty after a run like that.
Yeah, they are first and pushed back the all the way to their 6-yard line.
Looks like they're going to be marking out half the distance.
Okay, now we're
no,
half
that can't
the distance,
yeah.
So it looks like first and 17.
I think you're right, Dan. I think it is half the distance of the goal line. First and about 16.
Right back to lead. Same
play. Right back again. But this time, track down. I don't even think they're back to the original line.
No, there's Marley Dekel Javette. That's DJ, I think, as Coach Vincent told me they calls him. Much better job closing on that lead there. And that's how much faith they have in Braden Smith to make that kind of play. You know, your second and 13 plus is how I would normally categorize that. And you come back out and lead. You say, you know what, I think we can get a big chunk just off of our base run play.
Second and about 11. Palmer hands it off, and again looking for some room on the left-hand side. Will not get back to the original, to the first down line, pardon me.
Logan Van Sant, the ball carrier, tackled on
You're about 4 yards short.
Again, there's that game plan from Massey Brandon. They're coming out and lead. They're coming out and counter Trey. You see those pullers coming up to set that edge. It's looking like they're running the exact same spot, that huge B-gap opening up, but they're doing it in different ways. They want to get those downhill runs, and they're getting some space, but this time Sturgeon was able to close really quickly and make the play they needed to make to force the punt.
3 minute warning, so the clock stops at 2:50.
This is interesting decision from Sturgeon here. He got number 2 kind of 22 hanging out on the numbers by the wing here. I wonder if they're anticipating a short boundary punt. Yeah, there's that short boundary punt. Get a little bit more blockers right in front of those returners.
Picks it up. Finding some a bit of room up the middle and bringing it all the way back to about the 36-yard line.
They have to earmark that formation from Sturgeon there if the Vikings see that. You know, they had that earlier fake punt. They were able to just kind of send their bodies off to the field side and just gain the yardage. If Sturgeon's going to commit a player out on that boundary side, that may open up that fake again.
I think it was number 10, Jabari Marshall, who brought the ball up.
Correct.
First and 10 from the just inside the 36-yard line. McCammon's back. Nothing. And once again, just too much time. And DeVincent Massey, front line, takes advantage of it. And we have a big loss this time.
Scott Sherb and Wyatt Stee.
That's about a 12-yard loss on this one, Dan.
Well, you see when Sturgeon comes out in their wing formation, so they're bringing number 85 down beside the offensive line, and Massey's walking their linebacker up. So it won't really matter on this play, but we'll see if they start trying to take advantage of that with some counter plays, with some pullers. We can see them really trying to set the defense. There's that false pull again on the rollout.
And just no time. They are pressing. They are breaking through the line. Another big loss on the play. It's about another 12-yard loss, Dan. Like the right now, the front line of the Sturgeon Heights Huskies is just not able to manage the Vincent Massey Vikings defensive line.
Yeah, really patient from the Vikings there. You know, they showed play action, and when you're second in a million, you don't have to be so worried about that play action. You can be a little more patient. The D-line can, like I said earlier, pin their ears back and think pass, even if they're getting that run action in the backfield. You don't have to be worried about it. They still got to run for 25.
Zach Redekop and Christian Williamson are deep for the Vikings. Carson Turner.
Great kick by Carson Turner. Fielded at about the 24-yard line and coming back and looking for
Josh
something
Palmer
on his
on
right side.
Return is tackled on the play by Luke
tackle.
Bennett. Also one on that stop was Vincent
tackled
Campbell.
Tackled on the play by number 27.
That'd be first and 10 for the Vikings
from Sturgeon
with
Heights.
Yeah, honestly, great job playing that punt by number 9, Christian Williamson there. He tracked that ball really well. It went over his head. That's probably the best punt we've seen from Sturgeon today. He really got a good hold of that. Put it on the numbers right where it needed to be. But number 9 tracked that down really well and got himself some positive yards before the coverage team got there. Number 20 and number 27 combining on that special teams tackle.
So
different formation here from Massey Brandon. They're coming out in their bunch looks. We got an I formation and a bunch here.
Palmer under center, pitches it back. Looking for some room on the left-hand side and breaking a,
what a great decision.
A couple guys and looks like nobody between him. We've got a couple people cut up the side, but pushed out of bounds eventually at about the 18-yard line.
Is run out of bounds.
You know, that's a heck of a run by Braden Smith, and a lot of that set up by some fantastic blocking right at the point of attack.
But got to give credit to Daniel Visa there, making sure. Number 23, I talked about him a little bit tonight. What great speed, what great effort to keep six off the board for now. It gives you a chance to keep some points off the board here.
With fantastic wheels just to get himself outside of the coverage quickly.
Yeah. Number 8 is back in for the Vikings, by the way.
Under center, again, looking up the middle and finding a bit of room.
Braden Smith, the ball carrier.
Braden Smith continues to just chew up the ground.
He's a heck of a
tackle
running back.
Played by Derek Bapunin.
He had a great year last year, and he's been continuing it all this year as well.
3 yards to go for the Vikings.
That's neat to see. You know, they've moved away from that wishbone three running back package, and they're back to some of their more bread and butter here, and yet they're still able to just churn yards out. And again, they're back in that bunch. We'll see, do they try and go to the perimeter again to that side, or are they going to come downhill?
I think they found something.
There's that perimeter, but it's a toss counter tray.
Again this time, but it looks like this time Sturgeon Green Heights was looking, watching for it.
Yeah, there's Luke Bennett with that great eye discipline again. Yeah, a toss counter tray is a pretty unique way to run that play. It's a little bit slow developing, but if you can get the linebackers going the wrong way, and, you know, Massey Brandon just ripped off a 50-yard toss, so the linebackers got to be worried about that. So great eye discipline for number 27 to see his pullers and hit his run fit.
Vincent Massey has to move it. 21 seconds left in the first half.
They flip the bunch here.
Under center again. Palmer looks again right up the middle. Will have at least a first down. Pushes all the way through and touched.
Nope. Down on the one. And they'll take their timeout.
And Braden Smith carries the ball into first down territory. Tackle on the play by Malcolm.
7-0. 7 seconds left for Vincent Massey.
Well, here's a question, you know, do you go with that QB sneak or do you run your workhorse? Well, it looks like they're bringing in a jumbo package. Number 69 just came on the field here, so we'll see if that means they're bringing in an extra lineman. We see a skinny coming out, so that means they've got a heavy package going in. A little bit of confusion still here, too. Coach Vincent's looking like he's trying to talk his kids up real fast. Yeah, Coach Vincent's the head coach and that defensive coordinator here. He's connecting with his safety, number 20, talking to him about what he's expecting Massey Brandon to come out in here. So we'll see if Sturgeon can get this stop. It would be fantastic for them to keep this game 7-0 going into half. And Massey Brandon doing their best, and there's a timeout from Sturgeon. Let's see if the refs got it. Very smart from Coach Vincent there. He waited for Massey Brandon to come out in their formation, gave the timeout call. Now he's going to be able to talk to his defense and say, hey, here's the formation. Here's how we're going to adjust to it. So real nice chess game happening here, but that's the thing about football. It's a chess game, and everything looks great on paper, but you still have to execute. So we're going to see which team can play a little bit better on this last play of the half here.
You got to assume, though, that Vincent Massey is likely going to change their play now.
I wouldn't be surprised. That being said, they didn't show the play. They did show the formation. I think they'll stick with the same formation. It's something they wanted. It's something they trust. They've been having a lot of success on the ground so far.
That's true.
I think they'll come out in that dub-type power backfield set again. So we'll see if Sturgeon adjusts to it. They didn't change any personnel, so they didn't match that personnel grouping. So they clearly have faith in what their defensive line can do and their linebacks can close. I'll be interesting to see what number 53 does on this play for Sturgeon, because there they are coming out in that tight end set with that wing backfield. So a lot of bodies in the box right now.
Palmer under center. Hands off and looking for some room up the middle.
Down.
Touchdown, Vincent Massey.
And Coach Vincent.
Number 28, Braden Smith into the end zone for the
there's
Vikings.
That workhorse, Braden Smith. And Coach Vincent talking to number 20. Number 20 is the one who made that play. And Massey Brandon, I hate to criticize our officials here, but he was down before the one. And I'm going to be on Sturgeon's side, who's losing on the sidelines here. But nothing can do about it. We don't have replay. We're not the NFL. That's a great run play, and I wouldn't be surprised if Massey Brandon would have scored on the next play anyway. But that was a heck of an effort from both Braden Smith and from number 20, Vincent Campbell, on making that tackle.
Kicks the convert, and the score is 14-0 in favor of the Vikings with 3 seconds.
Well, 3 seconds left in the first half.
Now I'm hoping that I'm not going to get a fine from Commissioner Bannon for criticizing the call in the field, but video is video. So I have one last chance for a return here. Just need to see if Massey Brandon does have a squib kick or something they're going to do to try and keep the ball on the ground. and they showed the replay again. What do you think, Brian?
I hate to say this, but I think I agree with you in that they're showing it. Oh, they were just about to show it, but we're going to go live.
We maybe
live
don't
here.
Want to show that one again. I think we maybe keep that one off the airways. YouTube has it forever. The internet is forever.
Jabari Marshall and Owen Highland.
Our official number 52, a number near and dear to my heart. Unfortunately, maybe missing that call, but the game is not won on a single play.
And, you know, I always try to side with the side of the referees who've got a tough job.
You can't play the game without them. They're the most important position on the field. They're the most important team on the field. This game does not exist without officials. And, you know, for all you football players out there that aren't sure what your football career is going to be after you finish playing, please think about officiating. Officiate flag. Officiate tackle. Get involved. It's a great weekend job. Short kick.
Short kid, bit of a squib to keep the ball on the ground. Sturgeon Heights falls on it, and that Kerry will... Duncalf, oh, there's actually the 1 second left on the clock. I thought for sure that was 3 seconds. So there will be one play.
And it looks like the Vikings have come up with the football.
Well, let's see here. No, Sturgeon's ball, so they'll likely just kneel this out. We'll see if they try and take a poke here. But my guess is they're just going to kneel it out and get out of half and just kind of recover again. You know, just a couple big plays from the Vikings, so it's not like the Huskies have anything to be too worried about yet. Their offensive line needs to shore up some protection a little bit, and McCannon maybe needs to get the ball out a little faster, but they've been playing a good, solid game. It's just been quality football right now. Two scores can happen real fast in high school football.
Well, I absolutely agree. It just doesn't feel like the breaks are going McCammon's way right now.
Yeah, number 74, and I forgot his name already. You think I'd said it enough tonight. Newman Chiguato and Scott Sherb just have been terrors in the backfield today. So we'll see if they can keep that up.
He's lining up in shotgun, so I think he's going to take a shot. Oh, hands it off and looking for some room up the middle.
On the play.
That feels disappointing. We got a flag down on the far side of the field here. If they're blowing it dead, chances are we had something on the offense.
The legal procedure, Sturgeon number procedure. 66, 5 yard penalty. Remains first down.
That's a tough one. Plus, that kind of shows your hand a little bit, right? Now they're just taking a knee to get out of here. Coach Barabo's letting his quarterback know.
So that'll be first and 15 for the Huskies.
So just to kind of finish my thought there, again, players out there, get involved in officiating. Even if you're still a player in high school, there's a great opportunity for you to make some money during your high school playing days, to get to know the game a little better, and probably most importantly, to give back to a sport that's been good to you. There's my plug. Hopefully that makes up for me criticizing.
Well, you know, we can always second-guess something, and I think they will look at this later and say, okay, I made a mistake. But in the grand scheme of things, we'll see at the end of the game if it makes a big difference. That being said, folks, we are going to step away for a few minutes. Come back and join us. Halftime will be 10 minutes long, so come back to us in about 10 minutes. We'll join you in about 9, just as we're getting ready to start the half. Thank you for joining us at the Winnipeg High School Football League VIdruk Bowl between the Sturgeon Heights Huskies and the Vincent Massey Vikings. We'll chat with you in a bit.
Carson Turner gets the kickoff away. Christian Williamson on the return for the Vikings.
Bit of room and bring it up to about the 30-yard line. So that's where Vincent Massey.
First and 10 for the Vikings.
Up
with
14-0 in the second half. Starting the second half. We'll start their first series.
Well, here comes Massey Brandon. We'll see if they can stick with their game plan. Like, obviously, they came in knowing they wanted to feed Smith, and if they can keep doing that, they're going to be all right tonight. Their offensive line has been blocking in a fantastic way. Like, the running lanes he's had, you know, that's the thing about running backs. They often get a lot of credit and blame. The O-line is doing so much to open those holes up, but Smith is the one really making things work. Massey Brandon coming out in a split set out of under center, which is a unique look. But surprise, surprise, it's just another way for them to try and run lead.
First and 10, they start off with another yard run play and about 2 yards, maybe three on the
gain of 2 yards on the play makes it second and eight for the Vikings.
Yeah, for Sturgeon, you know, they just need to keep closing. They've been right there on so many plays. They've been every once in a while, the Vikings have broken off a chunk play. But as long as Sturgeon can keep closing, keep disciplined, they're going to be all right. But again, Brandon coming out in a new look and Sturgeon staying in that cover three shell.
Palmer under center. This time he will look to pass and he rolls to his left side, but knocked. Good cover
70.
And watch on the play. Knocked down, so incomplete pass. Second and about eight.
That'll make it
and there's that
and eight for
there's
the
that play from earlier when we had the two Vikings receivers coming off, kind of tapping their shoulders. You know, there's that sail concept again: a short out, a deep route, and a vertical on the outside. This time they only had the one short out, but it still couldn't quite get over number 70 for the Huskies, who had a great job batting that down.
So third and 7 or 8 yards,
and Highland back
Vincent Massey will be punting, and Sturgeon Heights should get really good field position.
Two dangerous returners here.
A low punt.
Ooh.
Off his knees and therefore and hit
the
right away. Number
10
from
Marshall.
Sturgeon Heights, and that is
Jabari
Marshall.
Always tough when you break that restraining zone, your own self, with that inadvertent touch on the ball there. It's going to make things a lot more complicated for you as a returner, but good job collecting and protecting the ball.
Well, the one thing about football, though, the ball just... You cannot consistently expect the way it's going to bounce.
Goes up on three. Third bounce usually goes straight up on you.
McCammon hands off and finding a bit of room up the center is number 22.
Owen Highland, the ball carrier.
Owen Highland, who is having a very good game so far.
Yeah, and there's, you know, they're not getting away from their game plan. That's important. They're only down two scores. You don't have to get away from your game plan yet. I'd love to see them start getting that ball out a little bit quicker.
Vikings shaking up on that last play. Gibson McNarland.
Yeah, Coach Steve's forcing the Viking defender to take a knee. Looks like he might be cramping up a little bit or a little banged up. Hopefully nothing serious, but by taking the knee, and you football players out there watching, if you're banged up, don't try and force yourself off the field. Take a knee, let your coaches make the substitution.
Coming off under his own steam, but at least initially a little bit of a stumble, and he's headed straight over and sitting down. First and 10, McCammon in the shotgun. Rolls to his right side, looking for something, but nothing. He's going to have to talk the ball in. And they hadn't changed the first down flag, so they're going second down again.
Now we know this will be third down here, and great tackle from Hudson Brousseau there. McCammon is so dangerous on the run like that, but they've been able to contain him all evening and not let him buy that time he wants to buy to force the ball downfield. So that closing speed from the Vikings has just been coming up all night.
Third and six or so. 9:15 left in the third quarter. Sturgeon Heights getting ready to punt. Have not scored yet.
Well, we'll see if we can get a very nice punt out here from the punter.
Great punt High in the air, fielded at about the 31-yard line. And
number four, there's that provincial team medalist coming through.
Side. Some great speed, but eventually tackled at about the 53-yard line.
A little bit of friendly fire from his blocker there. Always tough to see that. But there's that Zach Redekop. And I mentioned this earlier. You know, the information I got from Coach Steve is that that's a provincial 4x100 medalist there returning that ball. So for him to get to that perimeter, you never know when he's going to pop one.
He actually kind of ran into his own defender. And
yeah, there's that friendly fire. You're trying to make a block, you fall down, your turner falls over you, it's just bad luck. Back to the power eye for the Vikings. This is what they started the game in. And it looks like number 8 is off the field again. They've been just a solid rotation at quarterback tonight.
Pitches out to his left-hand side and finding a bit of room, but eventually brought down on the play by number 23, I believe.
They got the first down there, and there's that kind of waggle toss again, that wide receiver coming down, waggling down the line before the snap, making that block on the edge, just trying to set the perimeter for everyone to flood outside, and then once Smith gets going, he's just so dangerous. I can't say that enough.
I want to check that on the play. That was actually number 22, Owen Highland.
Oh, no, that would be the Sturgeon running back. 22, I don't know that the Vikings have that. My guess is that was still Braden Smith. My bad. I did not realize that Olin Highland was on the defense as well. I apologize.
Yeah, sorry, and maybe I made it a little confusing there, but it was Owen Highland who is actually looks like might be playing both sides of the ball.
Yeah, it looks like he's at the safety position. Number 20, the usual safety who made that tackle on the woulda, shoulda, coulda foot, touchdown at the end of half. He's on the sideline, so if he's banged up after that hit, that's a big loss for the Sturgeon defense because he's been flying around. But they're sticking with this cover three shell. They're not getting away from their game plan.
Second at about six.
Counter tray. Number 90 got the wrong arm.
Looking for some room to the left. Gets about 5 yards of it. It appears, no, they're saying about four. So third and two.
I think that's the first time we've seen Mahad Khan make a tackle there. And again, we're seeing the Sturgeon linebackers are doing a great job recognizing that counter tray. And that Massey Brandon's doing a great job still churning yards even when they do. Even though they see it coming, you still got to play football. You still got to make tackles. You still got to keep your feet moving.
Third down, and Vincent Massey's going to go for it. This time finding some room up the middle, and we'll have a first down.
That's tough, you know, when you can try and grind out lead for at least 2 yards a carry. You know, the philosophy that some teams have when you have that short yardage package down pat, when they know they can get 2 yards every time they run lead, they come out first and eight every time. And when you're playing first and eight, it changes a lot about what you can do on offense.
And I believe that was number 28, Braden Smith again. Dan, but correct me if I'm wrong.
No, that was Braden. Yeah, he's going to be seeing the rock a lot tonight.
So first and 10 from the Sturgeon Heights 33-yard line.
And there we go. Palm the receivers waggle down to set that perimeter, and there's Braden Smith up on the edge.
Yes, and good pursuit and tackle, but a flag on the play. Braden I think Smith they're going to call, and correct me if I'm wrong, a high tackle on this one, maybe even a horse collar.
That's my guess. I think the ref just indicated that he grabbed around the jersey there. I don't know that he was up in the head or neck area for the tackle, but I could see them calling that horse collar. Either way, it's that personal foul. They're going to be walking off some pretty serious yardage here.
It was a gain of about three. So this could take them all down to about the 15-yard line.
And those are those unfortunate, unnecessary roughness penalties. You know, it's nothing malicious. It's just bad luck. That's how you made the tackle, and that's how it happened.
And sometimes, I mean, you know, in just giving our defensive players a bit of respect here that, you know, it's not intentional. It's just the way that sometimes it just catches that way.
Absolutely.
Finding some room to the right-hand side again is Braden Smith, who just seems to once again just be turning up the field tonight.
He's their game plan. And when you've got a great offensive line that can open up holes and you just can hit it with speed downhill, that's a great job. Their right tackle, and I'm going to have to check his number here. I was just watching the replay there. My guess is it's Scott Scherf. I know that kid is very good at football. He is just collapsing the line of scrimmage right now, and he's creating such great running lanes for Smith behind him. Number 90 just absolutely making waves right now.
Second and two, Palmer under center. Looks like he bumped into his own player. Maybe the play didn't materialize and tries to push it up. Gets about 4 or 5 yards on the play and will actually get a first and goal from about the 1 yard line.
What a great play from that young quarterback there. So my guess is that was their toss counter Trey again. They gave the waggle look for toss. They gave the toss action out of the backfield, but we had the pulling guard tackle. So that toss counter Trey was probably coming back. Well, when the counter Trey didn't come back, what a great heads-up play from that quarterback to just get what positive yards he can. I've been really impressed with this number 10, Colton Malin here. Malian? I apologize for not knowing the name. But he's been really showing out when he's had his opportunities on the field.
Pitches out, finding some room to the right-hand side, and easily going touchdown! In and scoring the touchdown. Leave number 28, Braden Smith, once again.
Great job by Logan Van Senten there to set the edge. When the Sturgeon defender jumps inside here outside, you see him come down as that lead blocker. The Sturgeon defender is going to jump inside. That's what gives the lane outside. And Seven doesn't do much on the block, but his body positioning is what sets up the touchdown. That's one of those unsung plays. All he has to do there is be in the right spot and force the defender the wrong way, and you got 6 points on the board. So great job for number seven there.
Pending the point after, it is 20-0, 3:49 left in the third quarter for the Vincent Massey Vikings.
And number 89 adds the convert. The score is 21-0 in favor of the Vikings.
21-0 after the point after. Hopefully we'll see Sturgeon Heights. They really need to start try to make something happen soon. Dan.
Yeah, I mentioned coming out of half that they should stick with their game plan. They don't want to get away from it, and I do believe in that because I don't doubt for a second that part of their game plan is trying to get those shots downfield, but they opened the game up trying to hit that corner route that they've loved for probably, well, I know they loved it last year. I'm sure they loved it this year. It's a ball that McCammon throws really, really well, and the first poke they took at it turned into an interception. So I'm hoping that they can come back to that, get a little bit more of his confidence up, get that ball out quickly, and hopefully he's not feeling too gun-shy because he's a heck of a quarterback. So hopefully he can come out and start making some things happen here.
Ball is up, and it's rather short. Will come down at about the 30, fielded and picked it up, and trying to find some room, cutting to his left. And actually ends up getting a great return out of it, and that is number 10, Jabari Marshall.
That'll be a first down for the Huskies.
So Sturgeon Heights will take over for the next series at their own 41-yard line with 3:42 left in the third quarter, down 21-0.
Interesting to see if they come immediately out in their 5R package and start slinging here, but I think they'll still be in their 2-back, their sing look. Yeah, there it is. They got their wing back down, number 85 on the boundary side, the offensive left side of the field there.
McCammon in shotgun.
Quarterback, counter Trey.
Trying to find some room up the middle, but this, once again, the Vincent Massey front line read that really well.
And that's tough, you know. They have a great play call there. They bring the jet action. They pull the offensive lineman and try and create that quarterback counter Trey. And it's been really successful for them, but I know that's a play Massey Brandon has in their playbook. So this defense has seen that all year on the practice field. They're just not giving anything up on the ground, so great job from that defense, and they sure are setting to where Sturgeon comes out in. It'd be interesting to see if Sturgeon can start going a little more hurry up on them.
Loss of two on the play, so second and 12, and McCammon steps back in the play, and once again under big pressure, and just nothing for him to be able to do.
Brendan McCammon
gets back to the line of scrimmage or so, and well, gains about half a yard, so it'll be third and about 11.
Like, yeah, there's a lot to be said. I haven't mentioned his name tonight, and I really should have, but Adam McClelland is the defense coordinator of the Vikings, and I can't stress enough what a great job he and his squad have done tonight in keeping McCammon contained and keeping Sturgeon exactly where they want him. They clearly came in setting their defense depending on what Sturgeon comes out in, so that game planning has obviously paid out for them. They've still got a zero on the board. If they can keep that up all night, Adam McClelland, the defense coordinator, deserves a lot of credit.
Sturgeon Heights ready to set up to punt. Ball is up in the air. Kick off to about the left hand, to somewhere on the left hand side, but touched on the hands of Vincent Massey, and they will have to fall on it to make sure they keep it.
And the Vikings come up with the football.
Looks like we might still have a no yards here. I didn't think I saw anybody in that restraining zone, but I don't have that same view that the ref does. So.
Yeah, they're down there right next to it. I would agree with you.
No yards.
There's a flag on the play.
Sturgeon number 20, now, 5-yard penalty.
High school
down.
Football, I believe it. Yeah, it's only 5 yards.
Yeah, it's only five. It
and
hits
that'll
the ground.
Be a
and
first
as we found
down
out earlier,
Vikings.
If they catch it clean in the air and there's the restraining zone foul, the no yards, then it's a 15-yarder in our league.
Vincent Massey starts in the next series just short of the midfield stripe at their own 54-yard line.
A little bit of confusion from the Huskies here. They get adjusted well.
Pitches out and finding lots of room on the left side. Getting ahead of the receiver. And if he just can find a way to cut it, pulls him down. No horse collar tackle this time, just a good grip on the jersey.
Yeah. And I like seeing that not being called a horse collar. You know, the rule used to be worded, if there's a violent change of direction, then it's a horse collar. And they kind of got rid of that. I thought it was a really good way to do it. Vikings been setting that play up all night, just running the lead, but they've been bringing that over motion, that slot coming behind the running backs all night. And you know, for a lot of the plays, it's a wasted player, it's a wasted block. But when it sets up a great reverse like that, a great chunk play, that's just forethought. That's a great job from the Vikings to make that play happen.
And a great pursuit by Cameron Tycro just to make sure that they don't score another six. Palmer under center, hands it off, and going up the middle.
Take a guess.
Braden Smith. Gain of about, they're giving him about three.
That's a gain of about four.
Yeah, and again, lots of different looks. Lots of different looks to run their bread and butter, the lead, the counter tray. They come out in their wishbone backfield. Number 7 bumps out as a receiver late. Number 28, Smith, bumps over top of the fullback. They're in a traditional I, downhill lead. So even though they're showing all these different looks, they're always coming back to that bread and butter. Now we're seeing number 7 on the other side of the formation here. There's the waggle, shows toss, and there's the toss.
Toss. Braden Smith finds some room on the left-hand side and will get very close to that first down.
Yeah, got it by a few yards. And number 12 from Sturgeon there, the corner, doing a good job coming up in run support. Cameron Tykrow, number 7, I mentioned him blocking for the Vikings on that last touchdown they had. He's the lead blocker again here, but this time instead of jumping inside, the defender, number 12, stays outside, forces it back into his help, and keeps that from being 6 points. And yeah, it's a first down, but it's not a touchdown. You still give yourself a chance. Looks like we got Coach Vincent calling a timeout and getting the officials together with him. Wouldn't mind being a fly in that conversation. Can't imagine it being something that he wants to be talking to me about.
First and 10 from the 11-yard line. 9 seconds left in the third quarter. Vincent Massey once again threatening.
Running the fuck over, they ain't that fucking good.
What do you think that Coach Vincent's talking about right now?
I would not want to guess. I don't think that there's anything frivolously taken out of that.
So he's unhappy about something and possibly unhappy enough to actually use
just
up one of his timeouts.
Yeah, you hope that more of it was getting his coach. And his coaching staff did a great job there. He called the timeout, and his coaching staff was calling the players over, talking to them individually, talking to them as a group, and that's a great use of a timeout. And if that gives him an opportunity to speak to the officials about something that's concerning him, then okay.
Palmer hands it. Oh, the ball is out!
Well, we talked about just the bounces not going Sturgeon's way tonight, and what another great example of that. Number 7 unfortunately coughs up the ball here, but the Vikings are able to get on top, and Sturgeon just can't catch a break with that fumble.
That'll be second and 10.
So essentially from the line of scrimmage, we will continue second and 10.
Here's something interesting. We now have a 2-quarterback package on the field. So number 10 and number 8 for the Vikings are both out there. So we got Josh Palmer, who started the game, and Colton Malion, who's been coming in. So where is number 10 lined up right now? It looks like he's at the top of the bunch. And he's the lead blocker on this toss.
Looking for some room inside and getting it driving down. close to the first down.
Smith, the ball carrier, is number 10, Colton, got a little whipped around as the lead blocker on that there. You'll maybe see him get tossed by the defender, but he stuck his nose in, he kept his feet moving, and tried to open up as much of a running lane as possible for Smith behind him there as we go into the fourth quarter here. Looking like the worst flip in football, and it's having to go 109 yards when we flip the quarters here. I'm a big fan of when the ball's on the 55 for quarter change.
I'd like to invite you to stick around this evening for the second championship final this evening.
That's about as big a flip of the field as you can get.
Mathematically, I think it's the biggest. I suppose it could be on the half-yard line, but I don't even think we do that in amateur.
I don't think they do that in professional, do they?
Yeah, I don't even know.
So we will flip essentially an entire field. I can't blame you for saying wanting that field flip to be on the 55-yard line.
Yeah, the worst thing about it is when it's on a hash mark and then you get confused on why it's on the other hash. But
and it's going to be third and inches as we change ends for the end of the quarter.
Lots going on. So it is still third down. They didn't quite get the first down on the play. But Vincent Massey will be going for it.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised. Well, number 69 is working towards Coach Steves and Coach Dane on the sidelines here. It looks like he's ready to go in for their jumbo package, but not quite unleashing the big bodies yet. I believe that's who they brought in last time, was number 69 as that extra beef on their jumbo package last time they were down the situation at this very same goal line at the end of half as well.
Just making sure that they have the proper setting for the ball. Start of the fourth quarter, our last quarter of the 2023 VIdruk Bowl from Winnipeg's IG Field. And I say that because one of our teams is not from Winnipeg.
Yeah, if you didn't join us for the beginning of the broadcast, the last time these two teams met would have been, unless I'm mistaken, and very well could be though, but the last time they met in this stadium. And the game was settled down at this end zone in overtime with Vincent Massey Brandon taking that 20-14 overtime win over the Huskies. And again, this one isn't quite in that true playoff format. We got us a bowl game here to give some meaningful postseason action for these two teams. But these two teams are trying to get after it and finish their year on a win.
Pitches out to the left-hand side looking for something. Doesn't make it. Good stand by the Sturgeon Heights Huskies to a good goal line stand, and they will take over on downs.
Yeah, fumble or not, the Sturgeon coaches are a little confused here. They may have forgotten it was third down. It doesn't matter if they got the fumble or not. Their offense is on the field. So great stand from the Huskies, and I'm going to call back to number 12 for the Huskies. Cameron Tykrout turned that toss back inside to his help, made that tackle on the 10-yard line, gave his defense a chance, and his defense stood up. So that's a great play from that young man. It's a great example of you didn't make the tackle, but you made the play, you gave your defense a chance. Now, Huskies have a long field to march here, and they haven't moved the ball particularly well tonight. So let's see what they can put out here.
So McCammon from his own end zone takes the snap, hands it off, and looking for some room on the right-hand side and finding some room all the way out to the 15-yard line. What a great run.
Number 22.
Tackle on the play. Owen Landry.
First down. Yeah, Owen Highland there.
Owen Highland, pardon me.
Getting a great run. That's been a solid run. Again, you don't have to really change your game plan. You can keep going with what's gotten you where you are. But now is when you work your progressions. Now is when you start trying to use those things you've been setting up all game, all year.
First and 10 from their 15-yard line and hands it again to...
And there's Scott Scherr making another play in the backfield. He has been absolute tear on both sides of the ball. Massey Brandon had one of the best offensive linemen in the province last year, and honestly, his name's escaping me right now, but I do remember how dominant he was. And Scott Sherb was pretty great beside him last year, but really stepped into that same role this year. He has just been dominant all night.
Owen Highland lost two on the play, so second and long. McCammon back, and he will look to his left. Not much there. He's being chased down. Not able to bring him down quite yet. Getting back up to about the 15-yard line, the original line of scrimmage. Getting a little bit back, but not enough.
Yeah, unfortunately, just nowhere for him to go with that ball. And that's that blanket cover one that we've been seeing all night from Massey Brandon. At least I hope they run a cover one. I kind of take my eyes off their DBs. I've been watching the play a little bit more than I've been watching the football. So I hope I'm not looking like a fool out here and that they are running cover one. With their closing speed, what they've been doing all night, I wouldn't be surprised. Now, it looks like number five, McCammon's banged up on the play right now. He's grabbing at his ankle, waiting for Huskies to go out there and take a look at their downed quarterback. But this is probably where you're going to have to look at changing your game plan if you're not going to have McCammon left anymore.
Under our list, we have number seven, Ben Waters, listed as a quarterback, so we'll see if he's going to come in.
At the very least, we know that, well, I guess we don't know, but it looks like Sturgeon's bringing their punt team out, so it may have to wait till their next offensive series to see just what they can do. But like you mentioned, number seven warming up on the sidelines, and you can tell he's the quarterback because he's not catching his own passes. Can't risk the finger. Well, as they're looking at McCammon here, I hope that you're all going to be sticking around, even if you're not necessarily a fan of the upcoming teams, Kildonan East and Springfield playing this evening. But it's going to be another evening of great football here, kicking off at 8 o'clock tonight. So if you're enjoying the VIdruk Bowl, stick around. I believe that's going to be the Bramwell Bowl this evening, played between those two teams, Kildonan East and the Springfield Sabres, who are both coming out of the Northeast Conference of the Quad A Winnipeg High School Football League.
You will have to step out of our channel on YouTube and then come back into it later, as they are set up as two separate broadcasts, but we do encourage you to come back and join us for some more Winnipeg High School Football League action. Been a great game tonight, unfortunately. And I mean, this may be something that we've heard way too many times in life, but I feel that Sturgeon Heights has played better than the score is showing.
And that's your nice round of applause.
Yeah, I would certainly agree with that. Number five, really jogging off under his own there. So you hope that the ankle's not much. Maybe you're looking at more of a cramp. Not a doctor, not that on the field, just guessing. But he's certainly jogging off under his own power. And hopefully he's good to finish the game. You never want to see your high school career end on an injury. So hopefully he's able to kind of keep himself going tonight.
Head straight to the bench.
Carson Turner back in punt formation.
We're back to action now. Zach 10 Redicott minutes exactly left Christian in the fourth Williamson quarter, the final quarter of the VIdruk Bowl this year. Ball is up. Oh, no, it's going to head straight back and take the two. And
yeah, so that's going to put the Massey Vikings the with the ball on the 35. That's a new rule this year in amateur Canadian football, as we see Coach Steves informing his team that the ball is going to be on the 35. It used to be when you conceded a safety that the team scoring the points would get the option. You could choose to kick off, you could choose to be kicked off two, or you could choose to scrimmage the ball from your 35. But the Rules Committee of Football Canada here got together and decided kickoff is a play that we want to try and limit in football, particularly in amateur football. So that choice is no longer there. If you concede two, the other team gets the ball on their 35. And that was something that the Huskies took to their own advantage against Massey Winnipeg last week. Their quarterback sprinted back about 20 yards to take a knee late in the game and play that field position battle. So it was a really smart decision to use that rule to their advantage. And we see that rule coming into play right here as Massey Brandon comes back out in their wishbone.
That makes the score 23-0 with 9:33 left in the fourth quarter. Handing off and finding some room to his right-hand side.
Great flag from the official here. Little bit of an aggressive stiff arm, which is kind of a misnomer from number 28, Braden Smith here. If you're going to be doing that legally, your arm needs to be stiff. It can't be a punch to the face like we're about to see here in a moment. Right there, that shot to the head is going to get called every time. In fact, even a stiff arm, a straight arm, is illegal if it's to the head now. It has to be to the shoulder pad or chest area. Personally, not a big fan of that. If it is a stiff arm, it's not a blow to the head, but that is the rule, and certainly in that situation like we just saw, when it is more of a punch, a violent shot to that defender's head, it's nice to see some rules that protect defenders, and it's good to see that rule applied correctly there.
And that'll be first and
so that's a
for the
big 15 loss. Yarder. 15 yards. Takes them all the way back to their own 20-yard line. So that will be first and 25.
And something worth paying attention to is that's likely Braden Smith's first unnecessary roughness. Another new rule this year is three unnecessary roughness penalties is an ejection.
Palmer under center, hands back to Braden Smith, giving him a chance to try and make up some of that loss, but it will only get about 3 or 4 yards.
It looks like, and I mentioned that earlier, right? There's that faith they have in their run game. First and 25, lead. Let's see what we can get. But great job from number 27 to turn things back inside to his help, and then a great team tackle at the end there. Really good job from the Huskies to just collapse on Smith and make sure he doesn't get those yards after contact.
Second and about 22 yards.
Interesting to see if we get that bump out back into an eye here, if they're going to stick with the wishbone. Would be a good time for a screen. There's that bump out back into the eye, and now they're trying to take their shot.
For the first time in a while, Palmer slides back to pass and will run out to his left-hand side looking for something, but nothing there to pass to, and will eventually take it for a run and get some of the yards back, get about back to the original line of scrimmage. That will make it third and 10.
And that's Colton Malion again filling in there for Palmer. They've been kind of trading off at quarterback all night. And this is probably really promising for the Vikings. You know, when you've got a great grade 12 quarterback in Josh Palmer, it's kind of nice to see an heir apparent in your grade 11 quarterback coming in, being in a position to try and throw that ball downfield, seeing nothing there, and going to get some positive yards. Doesn't net them the first down, and they shouldn't be thinking about next year yet. But as a coach, I always appreciate seeing some of those plays from those up-and-coming players. Like I said, I don't necessarily have the experience with Massey Brandon this year. Maybe they've been running a quarterback rotation all year, but they've certainly been using it effectively tonight. Coach Steve's really just letting his team kind of get composed.
Timeout called by Pardon me.
Looks like he took a timeout, but my guess is he actually wanted to delay a game there. But I am conjecturing.
And I checked that too. I had said that was Palmer still out there, but it was Colton Malion.
I got you, Brad.
Good thing. So third and 11, Vincent Massey will be punting. Good punt will be fielded at a midfield, but it's out of the hands. This will be a no yards penalty, however.
Seeing a few of those tonight. It's an interesting thing from the Massey Brandon punter there. He really threw his hand down aggressively before that snap came out. And that's something that Massey Brandon has done for a long time. They do kind of a snap down on their offensive line where their O-line are set in a two-point stance and then kind of at the same time they all go down to a three-point stance. And it's interesting that they still run that because a few years ago, what was put into a snap down is if you even move all together, it's not a procedure penalty. But if the defense jumps, it's not a defensive offside either. If you're doing that in order to draw the defense offside, it is still illegal. So if that punter is throwing that hand aggressively and a defender jumps, Massey Brandon could be called for that.
So it looks like it was considered
no yards,
to be in the
yard.
So 15 yards. So Sturgeon Heights has great field position to start.
And number five is back out there.
From the 36-yard line. Yes,
screen.
Brett McKinnon is up, but the ball is tipped up in the air.
Is tipped away, incomplete, and that'll be second and 10.
Yeah, that was their most successful play in the first half was that screen. So this is a great time to come back to it. But Scott Sherb getting hands on it, gets a great rush. Doesn't necessarily retrace his steps, but because he gets up in the air and gets that hand on it, he completely disrupts that play and doesn't even give them a chance. Number 24 for the Vikings, though, Ryder Desjardins was sitting right there. So I don't know that there would have been many positive yards coming out of that screen if Sherb didn't get a piece of it, but great effort play from that young man.
Second and 10, McCammon in the shotgun once again, but will hand off and looking, finding some room up the right-hand side is number 22.
Oh, and there's the straight arm to the head coming back, but this one's likely going to be after yards gained. So we're going to see Highland's carry stand here. It is going to be a first down, but it's still going to cost them yardage. And there's that counter tray. Again, both teams run that play really well. They get those pullers out in front. They let 22 get in a run.
Replay here.
Yeah, 22 is going to put a hand right at the end on number four, up in the face mask area. And you just can't do that.
Sturgeon, number 22, 15-yard penalty. It's first and 10.
But when it's up in the head area,
so after yards gained, so it'll be a first down for the Huskies.
But it appears to be that you're correct. They are giving them yards gained, so it is first and 10. A loss of a couple of yards, but essentially starting from the same position again. Cameron hands the ball off to, oh, what a great play by
Owen Highland, the ball carrier.
Owen Highland
again.
And still keeping some faith in their offensive line here, the Huskies are. They're still running their jet action. They're still doing all their base stuff, but now they're getting away from some of those pullers, getting away from some of those false pulls, getting away from some of those short passing plays, which they may still need, but they're going back to those downhill runs to one of their best players. Right back at it here.
First and 10.
Just not there this time.
Oh wow.
That's what I get for talking early.
Well, but he did make them fight for it, work for it. I mean, Highland kept the feet going, kept letting people bounce off of him, kept things moving, and you know, although it's still a loss, it could have been a little worse.
Big, strong body keeping his feet moving there. And I'm not sure which Massey defender turned that back to the point of attack. I want to say it was number 24 again. If that's Redikop, I wouldn't be surprised. Ryder Desjardins, I think he was at the point of attack there.
McCammon is looking to pass downfield this time, and once again, he's just not getting enough time. The Vincent Massey pass rush has just been spectacular tonight.
Timotope, and that'll bring up a third down for the Huskies.
Getting a little chippy out there between Scott Sherman. Oh. It looks like he just went a little too far on that. And that's too bad. He obviously took some umbrage with something that happened with, I believe, number 12 of the Huskies. They were kind of jawing at each other there. And with him being doubled over, I wonder if there was a cut block or a block below the waist, which are legal. But I would love to have known what happened there on that play.
So we're waiting for the call from the referees, but...
Objectionable conduct. Vincent Massey, number 26. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Heights. In probably their best scoring position of the night. Was that?
Oh yeah, number 62, not number 12. He and Scott Sherb kind of got into it there. 90 and 62, jawing at each other, and I guess 90 just took it that little bit too far, and the official with the ball, number 52, decided he wanted to make sure that wasn't happening in an amateur game.
And was that 10 yards? Because I thought they looked like they were going to move 15. Anyways.
Owen Highland, the ball carrier.
Owen Highland is making some room up the middle and will fight for another 6 yards.
Along the play by Caleb Edwards. A gain of 5 yards on the play makes it second and 5 for the Huskies.
Owen Highland has really been playing well over the last few series for the Huskies.
He's got no quit. And you mentioned earlier that he was the one making some tackles, having been put into that safety position. So you've got now someone playing both ways, running that hard in the fourth quarter. That's a testament to his work ethic and the time he's put into the offseason. I know Coach Vincent does a great job in their offseason. He's clearly bought in.
Second and 5. McCammon's back. And
got
will
the ball
throw
up
the
quick
ball
to
up
the
in
corner.
The air. Oh, short of the intended receiver.
Finally coming back to that corner route. Number 90 being spoken to by the officials again.
And that'll be third and 5 for the Huskies.
Number 5, John, back at him here. The officials are going to need to get this under control here. There's just a little too much talk going on for an amateur football game right now. I'd love to see the coaches step in and try and correct their players as well.
4 minutes and 9 seconds left. And as expected, Sturgeon Heights will go for it. They could have, they're close enough, they could have gone for a field goal, but I'm assuming that a touchdown is what they really want. But coming back, and he's going to pass again.
There we go.
Caught and finding some room down the left side, down to the 5-yard line.
That's a nice crossing route out of the backfield there. They haven't shown that much tonight. They've been working their verticals, their corner routes, their in-breaking routes, and they bring that same concept. But now when 22, Olin Highland, comes down in pass protection, he leaks out of the backfield as that crossing route. We almost get that natural rub. Certainly not a pick play. That natural rub that opens him up and lets him get that first down on a crucial third.
3:25, first and goal from the 5-yard line.
Huskies playing against the clock now, too. There's 22 out of the backfield again. They're coming right back to the same play. Just a little out of reach. They clearly are seeing something there that the Brandon linebackers, like, yeah, it's been cover one all night, but these linebackers are kind of turning the running back loose out of the backfield. So they'll need to get that corrected if they want to make sure that they're not giving Sturgeon any life here. But that's a great pickup from the Huskies to realize they can try and exploit that.
So, folks, we encourage you also to stay with us just before the end of the game today. We will announce the VIdruk Bowl Player of the Game. McCammon hands off to who else but Highland. Highland. I know someone else by that name, and that's why I keep getting confused. But gets about 2 yards on the play, and once again, I got to believe they're just going to go for it.
Sure.
4 yards, they got 1 yard gain on the play.
And that was a little bit, probably the fastest I've seen the Huskies get on the ball there. I think they're starting to recognize that Brandon is setting their defense based on their personnel package. So when they went a little bit quicker to the ball there, they were able to catch the defense just not quite as set as they normally are. But great play from the backers to close there and keep that ball out of the end zone.
Here we go. Third and goal. The camera's back and he is going to look to pass again. Oh, and he had enough room. Fumbles the ball in the play, picked up, and there is nobody between
Nobody's catching him in the end zone.
That's number four from
Zach Redekop, the provincial medalist 4x100, going a little further than 100
touchdown
here for the score.
Number four, Zach Redekop, after the strip.
Yeah, that was tough for the Huskies there. We just had the same situation all night. Brandon came up in a 60 front. They had all their D-line up. They were bringing pressure. They knew they wanted to just kind of close everything down, and it just ran out of time. They just got that pressure there, and a little bit of backside pursuit. Great job playing the quarterback, and what a bounce to one of the most dangerous speedsters on the Vikings team, just off to the races. He's checking over his shoulder, and he doesn't need to. He just needs to sprint for that end zone.
McCammon had to be helped off the field. He was down for a few minutes afterwards, but not enough to keep him off the play. It is now 29-0 with 2 minutes and 5 seconds left in the fourth quarter of the 2023 VIdruk Bowl. Pending the point after. Ball is up, and that will make it 30-0.
Well, as we get to the kickoff here, again, interesting to see, does McCammon come back out after getting banged up there, or do we see number seven under center for the Huskies to close this game out?
Again, stick with us, folks. Just before the end of the game, we will announce the player of the game. Lots of interesting choices. We've had a number of players have really good games today. Now there is 2 minutes left. Let's see if the Sturgeon Heights can put something on the board for this end of this game, but does speak to how well the Vincent Massey Vikings defense has played this tonight, especially putting that pass rush on McCammon.
All right, Owen Highland got the ball in his hands one more time.
Fumbles the ball, and it is picked up by Vincent Massey.
Boy, those bounces have just gone the Vikings' way all night. You see that ball on the ground, and you just hope that your team can get on top of it. And one more time, the Vikings are on top, and here comes their offense looking to close out this game.
And that was that was just a ghost that pulled it because there was nobody around. He was just getting some speed up, and really, I mean, I'm not saying he would have gone all the way, but really had his wheels going, and then suddenly the ball just drops.
He's such a dangerous returner, and, you know, hopefully he keeps that short memory. Can't let that define him. Okay, McCammon is out on the defense right now. Looks like he's playing safety. So I guess he's okay if he's going to be playing both ways. Surprise, surprise, lead. But great play from number 90 there, I think. Yeah, number 90. That's, I had his name down. Yeah, Kerry Duncalf. You think I'd have it. I've been saying his name all night. He opened up the evening as our first returner. Great job coming off the edge there, recognizing that the ball has been handed off. He doesn't have to worry about the quarterback and making that play for a small-ish gain.
But a gain of about 5 yards, yeah. So second and five. Palmer under center, looks and hands it off again to, once again, it breaks a couple of tackles and should have enough for the first down, does have enough for the first down.
Yeah, Marley Dekel-Javet, he did a great job diagnosing that counter tray as they have all night, but he was just a little behind Braden Smith there, who broke that tackle and got himself that first down. So another great football play. Two players doing the right things, and just somebody has to win.
That'll be first and 10. Less than 90 seconds left in the fourth quarter. First and 10 from the Sturgeon Heights 29-yard line. And I would assume that Vincent Massey would just be content to chew up the clock now, but continue to hand it to Brendan Smith.
A good team tackle there, just kind of keeping themselves going. That's a good job from the Huskies defense to keep working the whole way, having a quick little team celebration, really getting after it there.
That'll be second and 10 for the Vikings.
Less than 1 minute left.
So here we go. Probably going to see a lead again just to kind of keep closing out. There's the lead right to Braden Smith. And again, good team tackle from the Huskies. Both teams kind of closing this game out the way they tried to play their entire years. Downhill running on the offense and team tackling on the defense.
42 seconds left. Third and about four. No, about five. Vincent Massey does not look like they intend to punt this ball away or try for a field goal. So,
no, I think they're just going to try and run out the clock here. We don't quite have the American 40 seconds to kill, but that Canadian 24 can tick away a big part of the clock. Well, they are hurrying to the line here.
Braden Smith finds a lot of room right up the middle. Nothing there. Breaks a couple of tackles and gets down to the 1 yard line.
Well, it'll be interesting to see if Coach Steves chooses to take a knee to end the game if he tries to put up one more score here. I certainly know what I would do.
Well, now you got us hanging.
Well, I don't think I should finish that thought, actually. But those who know me know what I would do. Here comes the Gatorade bath of Coach Steves. Team celebrating the bowl win here. Looks like they are going to be taking the knee to finish out. We have the Massey Brandon Vikings are your VIdruk Bowl winners here. Great job having a nice finish to their postseason. Getting a chance to end your year on a win is something that not a lot of teams get to experience. So that's the nice thing about this playoff structure that the high school league has adopted this year, is that, you know, even if you're not quite in that top eight provincial championship in Quad A, you can still get an opportunity to have a nice, meaningful playoffs. A great job from Brandon to have a dominant VIdruk Bowl win here.
2023 VIdruk Bowl winners, Vincent Massey Vikings. Congratulations to all the coaches and all the players. And we can now announce that the player of the games from Vincent Massey Vikings is number 28, Braden Smith. Fantastic game. Just a force through the whole game from start to finish down.
Yeah, it was a really great game to see. And it got away a little bit early, just some of those chunk plays. I kind of come back to that toss that started the second half. Massey Brandon came out, you know, they spent the whole first half in their wishbone formation, kind of grinding the ball out. Then they came out to start the second half in their bunch formation, collapsed the line down, got the edge, and Braden Smith went off for that 50-plus yard run. And that really seemed to be what set the tone there.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you very much for joining us tonight for the 2023 VIdruk Bowl from Investors Group Field. all of us here at the LRSD TV, thank you for joining this presentation. We invite you to join us back at 8 o'clock for the Kildonan East versus Springfield Collegiate presentation of our next football game. I believe you said it was which one?
I believe the Bramwell Bowl. Please don't hold me that if I'm wrong, and give me all the credit if I'm right.
There we go. Thank you for joining us tonight, and we invite to see. Looking forward to having you join us again in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Huskies, for a great season. And now for our VIdruk Bowl champions, could the captains of the Vincent Massey Vikings come forward for the presentation of your championship banner. There you have them, ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 VIdruk Bowl champions, the Vincent Massey Vikings. And we'd like to invite you to join us for the second championship game this evening. The 8 o'clock game is the Bramwell Bowl, which will feature the Kildonan East Reavers and the Springfield Sabres.
Get beside Dave there. He loves you.
Trophy this year?